Hi, King Creator fans! Let's start the day with a small Coke. Although I have to confess that lately I've been seriously considering going on a diet because I've already gained a few pounds. After cleaning off the sugary residues, measure and mark 7 centimeters on the can to proceed with the slicing. Once cut, remove those dangerous rough edges with the help of a mini pair of scissors. We'll make a couple more marks to the Coke can, one at the beginning of the ruler and one at 4 centimeters, which we will also cut. Be careful not to cut yourselves. This type of aluminum is usually quite sharp. I don't want to tell you how many times I've sliced my hand like a ham. Once we have both pieces of 4 by 7 centimeters, round the ends with scissors to get a pair of elongated ovals. These will be indestructible propellers for our light aircraft. Do you use these types of candles? My mother used to use them a lot when she wanted to pray or make a romantic dinner. But today, we'll use it to burn the popsicle stick that we'll use as a propeller support. See how the wood is turning dark? I have a strange taste for burning things, especially at campfires. I think in my other life I was a pyromaniac. Once we've succeeded twisting the wooden stick, measure the mark 2 centimeters from the center on both sides and cut them with the scissors. Get the super glue and place a little on each end to stick each Coca-Cola sponsored propeller in place. The most important part of the aircraft is ready. Now, we just need to create the central hole through which it will be fastened. Be careful with your finger. As you may have noticed, apply glue to the back of the propeller and unfold a paperclip. This will help it to rotate without stopping, navigating the most inhospitable skies. Insert the unfolded clip into the hole of the propeller and start bending it around the wood to hold it tightly. After cutting off the excess, add more super glue. We'll need one of these little jewelry beads that your sister has to insert it all the way into the propeller's metal wire. Cut the rounded end off of another wooden stick on one side and cut a little more on the other side. Drill a hole in the small stick and, just like the bead, insert it into the wire. Get a pair of super strong elastic rubber bands and tie them together with this knot that not even the Boy Scouts knows how to do. Make this pair of rubber bands a trio by attaching an extra one at the end. We have good news for environmentalists. Here, we recycle straws so that they do not harm our friends, the turtles. Attach the rubber band to the hook we just created and unfold another clip, leaving only one of its hooks. This will be attached to the other end of the rubber bands for the moment. Insert the last paper clip all the way into the straw and secure it to the propeller with a good dab of super glue. With pliers, cut a piece of popsicle stick, and then cut it even more. We'll need two pieces. With that, we'll have the finished rotation system for the propeller. But the rest of the structure is missing, which we'll make with these beautiful designs that I've drawn for you. Once cut out, begin to assemble the pieces following the order that you see on the screen. By the way, the material you see here is nothing more than foam. Did I mention that I work for a stationery store? Glue the straight ends of the wings together and cut the ends off of several sticks in order to glue them to the structure for support. A few days ago, I started a diet to lose the extra pounds I gained eating ice cream for all the inventions I brought you. And ever since I started, for some reason, everything reminds me of food. In short, these sticks made me imagine roasting some delicious hot dogs on a fire. After sharing my frustration with you, let's superglue the body of this plane to the wings and the propeller in the cockpit slot. Apply a little more glue on the back and attach the last missing piece so that it can take off. What an airplane! Creator King's designs are in fashion nowadays. Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. It reminds me of the little model airplanes I used to buy at the toy store in elementary school. Those were the days. Requesting permission to land, the following invention uses a small can of my favorite junk food. First, with a bit of paper, I'll clean out any crumbs that I haven't devoured. Then pick up a syringe. As if the mere fact of being a syringe is not already scary, they make them the size of dinosaurs. Once the nozzle of the syringe has been covered, find a matchbox and take off the cover with the scrapers. From there, cut the wider sides and turn them into space rocket flaps. 3 will be enough. Make a few cuts like you see on the screen to obtain these beautiful cardboard diamonds. Put glue on one of the edges and attach them to the syringe as close to the base as possible. Buzz Lightyear's rocket won't even compare to this one. Remove the support and, with a lighter, preheat a nail to 400 degrees. Then pierce it all the way through one of the quadrants. With the hole ready, let's begin with the electrician's work. Twist two copper wires together, one negative and one positive, then peel one of their ends. Twist these two and hot glue them together. Insert them all the way through the hole in the support, applying more glue at the end. Take a controller and a wiring circuit connected to a battery box. Not to mention this tube with cables. Find a small toy motor and start assembling the complete system. First, connect the motor pins to the white and green wires from the circuit. And then do the same with the yellow and blue wires to the tube with wires. Get the syringe support to which we added the wires and make the corresponding connections with the tube, which I assume is an electrical transformer. Insulate the connections with some insulating tape to prevent short circuits and the whole project from lighting up. Put four AAA batteries into place to start supplying power to the circuit. Don't forget the pair of AA batteries. One button activates the motor and the other one turns on the support line. Take out our favorite multi-purpose tool and create a small hole in the Pringles lid. Add some glue around the hole and insert the motor stick. We'll need even more glue to attach the battery box and transformer to the lid. Finish by gluing the syringe support at an angle of about 45 degrees. Cut off the rounded end of a popsicle stick and then cut it in half. After piercing the bottom of the can and assembling everything in place, put a 500-gram weight under the can to prevent it from collapsing with the firing power. Add a group of magnets to activate the force of attraction and proceed to prepare the rocket by adding some of your favorite perfume. Mount the rocket on the platform and let the fun begin. You can point it in any direction you want. We hope you have good aim as it takes off with quite a lot of power. Not even the Army has a little toy to demonstrate such a display of power. It's pretty fun, but we strongly, for the love of God, ask you not to use it to take revenge on your brother. Home run! For the last invention of the day, we'll need a large and powerful drill, in addition to a 3D printer, which we should all have at home by now. For this last one, we'll have to print the pieces to assemble the propeller. Be patient, as the 3D printer usually takes a long time to do its job. In this case, 6.5 hours. Look at what a beautiful finish it has, but I can't imagine how long it would take to make a more complicated piece. Once dismantled, we can start to assemble them with this one that I think I've seen before. Take the first propeller and contemplate its beauty a little more. I just love 3D printers. Sand the roughness of the base that all printed pieces come out with so that they fit together easily. They should be as smooth as possible. Now, with the box cutter, make several cross marks on the base that we just sanded. It should look like it does in the video. If we fit the pieces together now, they may not hold in place. See how the piece moves? That's not right. So let's correct it with the super adhesive tape that fixes everything. Place several layers of tape on each side that will fit together to fill in the gaps so that they don't move. For me, three pieces were enough, but you can use as many as you need. Cut a slit in the pile of tape on each of the folds to make it stick well to the surface, then put glue on it. Now, start assembling the pieces and you'll notice how they fit perfectly without moving. Just look at what a perfect, beautiful thing. Well done! With such long, smooth, and curved blades, it's the perfect propeller for our skateboard. To install it, we'll need a short piece of wood that has a diameter similar to that of the propeller hole, and at the same time fits in the drill hole. Now all that's left to do is to devise a system to operate the drill and, of course, mount it on the skateboard. First, fasten a wire around the drill at the height of the button. Twist it, and then fasten it with adhesive tape. If you pull on it, you'll see how the drill is activated and starts to rotate with full power. To mount it on the skateboard, we'll use another method that's reversible, because obviously we need the drill for other things, and I don't think your dad would like to have to buy a new one. So a bit of super strong gray tape will do. it's time to take a ride on our new Propeller skateboard. It's not the fastest on the market, but at least you won't have to move your foot again. You'll simply have to sit down while you pull a little cable. Wait, I didn't pull the parking brake! Thanks for watching our inventions made out of household items today. Follow my channel if you'd like to learn more about making simple yet incredible inventions. Also, click on the link to see more videos about my amazing inventions. Click on the link to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my videos. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial.